Gabriela.
O nome dele é Jean Claude Van Damme, filho de Eugene e Eliane. É pai de Christopher, Bianca e Nicolas. Tem 40 anos, nasceu em Bruxelas, na Bélgica. É ator há 18 anos, mais ou menos. Fez 27 filmes, se envolveu na direção de vários deles e é um dos ícones do cinema de ação. Está no Brasil para divulgar o seu filme mais recente, Replicante.
My life is your life.
Jean Claude Van Damme is Replicant.
Boa noite, Jean Claude Van Damme.
Good evening.
Good evening. It's still daytime.
I
understand. Good evening.
Let's
good
make evening. It as if it was night.
I'm sorry.
Okay? Do you have a nickname?
Nickname. From which way of?
I don't know.
From France.
Have you ever had a nickname?
Yeah, from my mother, Cisco.
Cisco, and yeah. It means?
Little rabbit.
And after your mother, did you have any other kind of nickname?
Yeah, like JC, you know. Hey, JC.
But how do I call you here right now? Mr. Van Damme?
No. Call me Jean-Claude.
Jean-Claude. Okay.
Or JC.
You have a beautiful name from Farenberg. Where does your artistic name, Damme, come from?
Van Damme.
Van Damme.
Because Damme is being dumb.
Oh, yeah, no. Sorry, yeah, Van okay. Damme.
Yeah, Van Damme. Van Damme was a friend of mine, a very mature person. Mm-hmm. And I met him when I was 18, and he was very into sponsorized sports people. And he was like 60 years old, but in very good shape. And I told him I'm gonna go to America to become a movie star because I like you so much. You helped me with my sport training and the money.
In martial arts?
Yeah, he was behind me, invited me to his big house in the North Sea in Belgium, so I was able to run in the sand, good food, because I came from a medium family, you know? And I said, if I'll make it, I will take your name Van Damme as an honor.
Oh, beautiful. And, nice of you.
And 2 years later, he died of cancer.
Oh.
But he knew my success before he died.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
You went to Hollywood and you became like a taxi driver before being a movie star. Taxi driver, pizza deliverer. What else? Fabric,
bouncer,
carpet layer, and
yeah,
but it was nice, wasn't
it? Because in life, if you have a goal, and this is your goal of the mountain, you have to look at the goal, no matter which way. Don't be disturbed by the taxi, by this, by that, by pizza, by the goal is there. But sometimes you have to go step by step, knowing goal is there. But if you look at the goal before the step, you fall down.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yes, I do.
I mean, it's very simple, but God is simple, and that's the way I understand from God how to become strong again. Look at the goal, but not too much, knowing it's there, and go step by step.
Do you keep being simple after all the success, all the money you made and everything?
I mean, money, I don't make so much money.
Why not?
You're not talking to Bill Gates here. You're talking to an actor, you know?
Yeah, I'm a very successful one.
Yeah, but I'm not, I don't own a huge TV station because people think actors, they make millions and millions and millions
of
dollars.
They usually do.
Yeah, on the Inquirer. But only few of them in my hands are making between 10 and 20 millions. And you have like hundreds and thousands of actors. They are making like $50,000, $75,000. They do it because they love acting. But your question was?
How do you keep simple, being simple, if you do?
Yeah. Being simple has nothing to do with money. That's why I lost you. Being simple, it's say yes and no. No, maybe. That's being very simple. Being simple, it's...
You do say no to what, for instance?
No, yes, being simple, be honest. If I don't like this show, I will walk out and being simple.
I'm asking you, normally, regularly, what do you don't you like at all when you say no? No, I don't do this, I don't want this for me.
Depending on the mood of the day and the nanosecond of your life.
Are you too moody?
Right now?
No, always.
No. I'm a happy person.
Are you?
I love life.
Good.
But sometimes I feel bad also. Uh-huh. Because I care for people. And sometimes you feel bad. If you're very emotional and sensitive, you can be very strong. But it's beautiful for a man sometimes to show his emotion.
Do you cry very often?
Crying or not crying has nothing to do of being emotional.
Well, but
if you want me to tell, if you want me to tell the people of, I'm crying a lot. I'm crying a lot because music make me cry. Yesterday I cried on a TV show because I saw a child who came to see me. Am I crying? I'm not. I don't know if I'm crying a lot because I cannot prepare crying. You don't fake crying. Even in acting. You're crying, it is for real. You bring back something from the past.
Do you keep a connection with Belgium? Or not anymore?
Yes, yes.
Do you have your family there still?
Yes, my father, mother, but now they bought an apartment in the south of France after all those years because I became very successful and they never won nothing from me. By the way, I'm making money, huh? Mm-hmm. Go back to the last question, but I'm not making big money. Maybe one day to help people. Why not, huh? Uh-huh. I can dream, right?
Of course.
Okay, so my parents, they're between the France and Belgium.
Mm-hmm. And you live in LA?
I live in LA right now.
Do you like it?
That's where my life is right now. My family and my business.
I know you do speak a lot of language. Do you speak also Flemish?
Not really. I don't speak too much language.
Or you speak Italian?
No.
I read that.
Yeah, I said that.
I read that
too. But you speak I speak Chinese if I want. I speak
Japanese,
all that stuff. I speak everything.
But you do speak French for sure. You do speak English.
Yeah.
I read you. You could speak Italian also.
I can understand Spanish because a woman took care of me when I was young, from 1 to 6
years old. A nanny?
Yeah, sort of.
And she was a Spanish.
Yeah. And then she left, and then I lost all my Spanish. And then she came back when I was 18.
Well,
16.
You are here to promote your new movie, Replicant.
Yes. Yes, Gabby.
Is Brazil a good market?
Gabriella.
I like you speaking Italian, you see?
Gabriella.
Is Brazil a good market for your films?
Every market is good for my films if it's a good movie.
Yeah, but this time I feel that you are...
It's like in Brazil, like, for example, that funk dance...
Funk, yes.
It's what you call it?
Funk.
It's funk.
Funk.
For sure it's funk.
Funk.
It's nothing other than funk, right?
No, it's funk.
It's funk dance, right?
Yes.
It's not...
No, not the one with...
No. But so they are changing stuff, you know? They go from flavor to flavor. So in this movie, we have the action, we have the drama, but I'm really crazy. I've got a problem.
Wow.
And I can bring back a lots of memories, and thank God to Ringo Lam, my director, who really knew me for many, many years, and he made a film with me when I was in trouble. Oh. And he
what
saw
kind of trouble?
You know, mental trouble, you know, moral, whatever, in trouble. Mm. And he saw that, and he saw another man coming to Hong Kong, being very humble, saying, I want to do this, and you go, I want you for this to do this, and da, 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 da. So he remind me. It was painful for him to remind me how bad I was. And then Replicant, it's a new life. Uh-huh. Even if you F up in the real life, at least be pure in a movie mm-hmm. called Replicant. If you cannot make in this life, in the past life, and no, even if you're good and training, but maybe if you're gonna fail, at least make it good for once in Replicant.
And you do care about everything in your movies, isn't it? You can write it, you can,
Well, I tell you what, because I'm a control freak. Not because I want...
Are you obsessed?
No. I want everything to be fine. I want people to work together, to be happy. I want involvement. I want the color to match. I want your chemistry. Before the TV show, I want your chemistry and my chemistry. I was praying for that to happen. So I send you love from distance. It sounds bizarre, I know.
No,
it
sounds
But it worked
nice.
For me. See, now how we're like... It feels like I know you for like at least 15 to 20 years. Right or wrong? Right or wrong?
Right.
I'm not saying that to show off with you.
And I'm saying you are right.
So anyway, what was your question again?
I was talking about your kind of obsession with your work.
So I want everybody to match color, chemistry, so then we have a good movie. And Replicant was like that. And also when you're involved in the script, And the producing aspect, to know where the money goes, and the lighting is important for the mood. You don't have the time to get lazy, and I'm a lazy person.
Are you?
Because I'm I don't know. I have a certain level of intelligence. I don't know if I'm that intelligent or that intelligent, but I'm somewhere there, right? Uh-huh. So if I don't have something to think about it, I get lazy. And when a guy who gets something, a gift from the nature and doesn't use it, his self-esteem is going down.
Let's see a little bit of your film. Uma ceninha do replicante.
They're going to show finally.
If you kill me, you kill yourself.
No. We are showing this one because people can see you doing a double part. You see?
My life is your life.
Jean Claude Van Damme is Replicant.
E vamos fechar este bloco com o quiz de hoje. Qual dos seguintes filmes foi dirigido por Jean Claude Van Damme? Desafio Mortal, O Grande Dragão Branco ou Soldado Universal? Resposta, depois dos comerciais. Até já. O nome dele é Jean-Claude Van Damme. E qual dos seguintes filmes foi dirigido por Jean-Claude Van Damme? Desafio Mortal, O Grande Dragão Branco ou Soldado Universal? Pois saiba que foi Desafio Mortal, um filme de 1996 que conta a história de um jovem lutador que vai trabalhar como marinheiro e é convencido a participar de um torneio no Tibete.
Take me home. And take care of Billy Red. The kids.
Well, you asked me why just a fight? Do you have problems with this?
You missed that.
Doing my best.
Trying. By the way. I know why you're so successful.
Why?
You're cool. You make people feel good.
Really?
You have the eyes of a complete woman. Complete woman. Thank of a God. Lover, of a mother,
Thank
of
you.
A young girl. Your eyes are... You've seen a lot in life.
Thank you.
And you've been suffering a lot in life.
Well, not really. Let's talk about you now.
Okay.
Well,
I feel for you a lot.
You ask it. Are you going to show just me fighting? And this is a problem for you, the recognition of your talent as an actor?
No, it's not a problem. We have great fight scenes and different fight scenes because Garrett is not like the Van Damme. He doesn't care about beauty. He cares about efficacy, destruction. He's sick. But we have great moments with the twins when they talk to each other. Uh-huh. The difference of makeup and face and expression. They don't even look like... Garrett doesn't look like Van Damme.
Beautiful. My exact replica.
What I'm asking you is, have you suffered of discrimination or preconcept because of your start as a fighter? Uh-huh.
Yeah. When you get into something,
yeah.
If you're very good as an anchor, right, with your TV show, uh-huh. It's very difficult to go to the boss and tell him, no, I want to do cartoon.
Yeah.
So, cartoon? Why? I mean, you're making so much tickets. So it's difficult to convince a bank called Equal Studio to tell them, no, I want to play, no, like something different. You know, if you do it well, they'll go, come on, find your own. Then you have to find your own money and do it. And if it's a hit, they say, oh, it can do everything. So I will succeed because now I'm in that cycle of wanting back life.
Wanting back life.
Yeah.
Did you produce?
No, but I was very involved into the full because I brought to a company a risky movie. It's an expensive movie, you know? I mean, not too expensive, but enough expensive to have some damage. Mm-hmm. And also, they do a lot of TV show there. So they're very well trained and have studio and they have everything, snow, water, everything, you know? And it's 1 hour from L.A. 1 hour for the actors.
Flight
yeah,
hour.
If I have a wife, I want to go see back my wife. I go, why? I go, because. Yeah. Because what?
Where do you live in L.A.?
Yeah, I don't live in L.A.
Your family, where are they?
I lied to you. No, I live in Los Angeles, in Santa Monica.
Santa Monica is so beautiful.
Beach. Yeah.
So beautiful. I had
if you
son
come to Santa
there.
Monica, you can come by because I've got a house there and a townhouse. A townhome, so you can have a place for guests.
I had a son living in Malibu once.
Oh, yeah?
Going to the proper dine university.
Wow.
Yeah, beautiful.
Expensive.
Well, yes, I was working hard here.
You must make a lot of money.
No, I try. I do my best. Well, talk with me about the two characters you do in Replicant. What is the story about?
The story, to me, you have to go see this movie this way. We have a killer, and he's untouchable and traceable.
This is the one.
Yes.
You are a killer.
Yes, but yeah, he has a problem. And they made this one a replica of the killer, the guy with the blue jacket. Uh-huh. And that's me being young and everything. So, to chase the killer by trying to wake up his memory. So I will come out of a big placenta at the age of 40, you know, not doing nothing about life. And
oh, like that, yeah.
I will have a computer, yeah. It's good stuff. I will have like a computer of a 40 years old, but the disk will be empty until if I touch and I kill flesh, not understand. Like, because the 40 can sponge to that level. And then slowly they're gonna bring me by force to the crime of the scene, the scene of crime, I'm sorry, to try to wake up my memory, but I'm not the same type of person because I was created artificially by humans. So for once, because life, I mean, and the mother, but for once, a human being did create better than the creator. And the creator is happy about that.
It's a very good idea, isn't it?
I mean, if I create a child, Gabby, if I have a son, I want my son to be better than me. They all hope for God to help them. No, I mean, God wants you to help yourself because he made you better. Of course, he's powerful, he's the best. We all know that because we're made of him. But we have to recreate better. And that's what happened with Replicant. Even if it's like a DNA product, Nothing is wrong in life if you do for good. I'm against, you know, all the bad stuff in life, but if you do something for good,
if you believe in it,
and if it's for good, good intention, I think God loves that.
For instance, what kind of father did you become?
Did I became? Well, I was always a bad father.
Well, I don't know, because
I say bad father because you think I'm a bad father.
No, I'm actually...
Oh, come on, don't kill me, huh?
No, but listen, I was always a good father, but I was very busy with my career.
So, not a present father.
Exactly. So, when the rope came in and I grabbed it, I didn't let go. Bloodsport, Lionheart, Time Cop, Double Impact. I did all those movies back to back, three movies a year. No! I was the more prolific actor because I signed myself to so many people because I was so hungry and one movie was not released in time, then they all came anyway. And then I became more smart and less burnt out.
Less anxious, probably.
Of course, because now I've got anything I want, the way I wanted, the banks and everything. But that's not... No, I spent. No, I sold a big house and I bought a small townhome so I can hear my children left and right playing.
And you have a quality time with
them. Wow, you're on the phone, doing business, but then between the phone, you're searching for papers, and then you see the Bianca. Hey, I told that thing. I never knew that in the big house. When you have a big house, you don't have time to listen to your son, your daughter. When you have a small house, it's a big family, they're together. It's beautiful.
You were back with an ex-wife, isn't it?
Yeah.
You remarried.
Yeah.
What the hell does it mean?
But what the hell marriage means?
Yeah.
I mean, who made the rules of marriage? I mean, God?
What does
or
it
humans?
Mean? What does it mean to be married?
No, it's like... Okay, it's difficult to explain you that. Don't hate me, guys, but I mean, that's my point of view, and I'm going to be very honest. Love is love. I've got five children. Which one I love the most? What? Equal. No, if I love a woman then and a woman there, I've got still the same feeling. I still care for her past and her, you know. So, yes, I'm married to the law, and of course it's beautiful. But marriage, the word marriage, really doesn't mean much for me.
You don't like it very much.
It's like you feel like you're in prison. I don't have any ring.
I can see it in you that you don't like the word marriage.
No, God doesn't want to be married to us. God is in us. Already, I mean, he doesn't invent any rules. Love is free. Love is free. You go with your love and you choose whatever you want in life. What comes to you and you feel good about it, accept it. Don't refuse it.
Comerciais e a gente já volta. Acompanhe a agenda do programa Gabi no site da Rede TV e participe. Envie sua mensagem também pelo fax 0-11-4166-7070. O nome dele é Jean Claude Van Damme.
What is it to be an actor for you?
Ah, very good question. You ask the best question of all the shows and you're equal to Google. That's not because it's
like
for it's for two reasons. Because you're both very good and you're also both very charming. And it's not to be politically correct, really. You're fantastic people. very warm. Anyway, my first, to be an actor, to be physical, to show the world, to prove my parents, because maybe when I was a young kid, I was very small, skinny, I didn't have any attention from people, so I trained karate, started to train and fight and to become more and more strong. And then I became a champion, now I wanted to have a gym, now I want to be a businessman, now I want to be an actor, and everything I achieved. And then when I became an actor, nothing changed. It's like, wow, I'm the same guy, how can I go higher? Huh? And then I relearned to find into the acting, which I loved a lot because I love to communicate with people, because what acting bring me the most, it's not the movie. It is able, it's me to be able to talk, you know, and to have people looking at me and trying to do my best from my experience to try to give them good advice. And if I don't think they are good, then I will control my words and make them neutral.
Have you ever been in the theater, in play, in a play, or just in the movies?
Only movies.
Don't you feel attracted?
Oh, yeah. I should do stuff like that. Huh? You see, you're the type of woman, if you're behind a man who's got talent, right? You're the type of woman who can really direct a man. I believe, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Let's say you and I fall in love, which will never happen, right? I mean, don't ever say that, because that's against God. God doesn't like when you say it will never happen. Everything is possible. But you're the type of woman, when you see something good, you're so smart, you're a businesswoman, and you're very intellectual and sensitive. You know how to direct a guy to rebound his career, going from a good play, why, critics, and then action together. It's a good package. It's a very good, thank you, advice.
Why the hell are you talking to me about this? I'm asking you if you would like
because
to be in a play.
Because you saw from my point of view, it will be good for me to do a play. You were thinking for me.
Yes, it's true.
So I explain you what is inside your brain for people to understand, the audience, to see how smart you are.
Do you know, you said something very funny to one of my producers. I liked it very much. You said, she asked you, when did you start to act? And you said, when I start to lie. And it was about three, when I was like three. And you do act all the time. I don't know if you know this, do you?
No, hold on a second. Because when you're three, four, five, you don't lie when you're three, you're pure. You lie around 11, 12, 13 because you're in the path of life. But that's, lie is not acting. It's the first step of acting. Then you get disappointed. And now my interview with you here, it's very, I mean, it's truthful. I mean, it's like, it's really face to face, eye to eyes. I mean, you can look at my eyes.
I'm not saying that you were lying.
No, no, but what I'm
acting.
Saying to you at that time was an acting, like what we think is acting, you know? And now it's like, it's more like, if you want to be a real actor, you have to believe so much into your, Al Pacino, for example, when he come out of a movie, and he come out of a toilet, his zipper still open. He doesn't know who he is. Hey, Al, huh? He's still in that role. It's fantastic. But he loses himself. It's very hard, you know, because you go from one place to another with your full physical and mind attention. So your enzymes are going to disturb your chemicals. Understand that. And they have to come back to something normal, which is you. It's not so easy as a good actor. That's why good actors are suffering. I mean, the Jeremy Irons, the Al Pacino, the Richard Burton's, all those, Brando, all those great actors, because they are giving so much to be that, I want to play Gabby, and they become Gabby, and then they have to go back to Al Pacino. It's tough, and they have a phone call, the agent, now I have to play El Dorado, you know?
How do you feel when you act?
Me, I just kick.
Do you use a stuntman?
Oh, this is bad, what I did.
No, it's good.
There's no class.
No, it's okay. It's you. Do you use a stuntman?
What, no glasses?
No, no. It's you playing, talking. It's nice. I like you. I like you. Do you use a stuntman?
How much do you like me? From 1 to 10?
Very much.
From 1 to 10.
1 to 10, I would say 8.5.
Oh.
the rest... let's keep in the doubt, you see?
No, let's keep just a little table between us.
That's good. Do you use a stuntman?
Of course, you have to.
Because of insurance and safety and everything?
But when I do my fight scenes, many times it's me. All the time it's me. Because the slow motion kick and all that stuff, especially when I do the twin stuff, I don't want... In slow motion, you can see a different style, a different shape of butt or back, or you understand? Slow motion, you can. But like when I have to hang from something and it's a 3-hour shot and it's a gun unit and I've got to wait 3 hours hanging and we don't see my head, I go to the beach, take some sun.
You were once a dancer.
Yes.
How good dancer?
I think very good.
Very good?
I think very good.
Let's see a little bit.
Ah, but
ele dançando.
No, not from the movie.
Oh, yes, just a little
show
bit.
Ballet. You have to
well,
show ballet.
Well, it's not ballet. It's a nice scene of you dancing. What kind of dance you used to do? A modern or the classical one?
Classical.
Classical. You were dancing a little bit earlier. You were dancing.
Ah, it's so bad, this movie.
You don't like it?
Oh, when I see it.
Why?
The cutting, the acting.
Every time you see your movies, you feel like that? Very
No. Some are good. It's good film. But something is nice. The charm is there. The one thing, the life, you can see life into my flesh. You understand the aura? The aura is there, and that's the charisma. But the acting can be so much better. Slow motion. Oh! And me, I go, what? It's time to change.
Agora vamos para os comerciais. E até já.
Like you.
Romeo!
Maggie! Waste him.
No!
May I put some questions from the internet users?
Please.
Okay.
They can use me?
Yeah. Thiago Rocha from...
That's true.
Andradina, 17 anos, em São Paulo. He asks, what do you think about Julia Roberts? Do you think about her?
I think she's the best actress. Because she's emotional, she's deep. She's like, she can be passionate. And when she smile,
She's so beautiful. She's just a sandwich.
José Ivan Fortado Leite, comissário de bordo de Jaboatão dos Guararapes em Pernambuco. What's your religion? Do you have one?
No. Okay. I believe in me.
And in God?
But because God and I were partners. Like, God isn't... Guys, let's stop to bullshit ourselves. I mean, why we should to listen to some religion saying, if I put a skirt above my knee, I go 2 days in hell if I do... It's time not to be very honest with each other. I'm part of God. God love me. My religion is God. Not the Catholic, not the Muslim, not the... Because it only bring wars. For many, many years, all those religion, they bring wars. And they're killing people. So I don't want to talk about religion. I want to talk about God. God has no religion. God has love. His word is love. And evil, if you reverse, become L-I-V-E, called life. Evil doesn't exist. Only for people to be controlled by fear. Because you're afraid in life, so you are controlled by religion, so you're afraid to do something you want to do for yourself. And God wants you to be yourself. Want you to be rich, happy, poor. Just be what you want to be. But do good. Don't do bad. That's my religion.
Marco Antônio, engenheiro do Rio, de 36 anos. Simone Santos, da Fonseca, 24, São Paulo. Vânia Fernanda, 35, artista plástica de Porto Velho, Rondônia. Why and how did you get involved with drugs? What kind of drugs did you use? You had this problem many years ago.
Tell this gentleman, he know the story, he can go to the web, to the
Zed,
to the Schmidt, to the Inquirer, he know my past. This is, to me, a bad history. I turn the page, I just talk about God, he talk about drugs, so leave me alone. He is on the other side of the religion.
Okay. Marco Antônio Benini Jr., 20 anos, Santo André, São Paulo. I would like you to give some tips and advice to young people that want to have a body like yours.
First of all, on bodies, it's like a blueprint. It's like some people are wide shoulders, small hips, or big hips, small shoulders, because they were built that way, because they were chosen to be that way without knowing even. So you've got first to adapt food to your own anatomy. For example, I've got high cholesterol. Nobody knows.
Do you?
Yeah, so I only eat vegetables and
fish.
Only fish, no oil, no butter. And that's what I like to eat. And by the way, rice and tofu and beans and all those products are very inexpensive, and they are better than other products who can hurt yourself and your life. And then training, of course, you go to the gym 3 times a week. Don't force yourself. Don't work heavy. Because if you work heavy, you're going to have tendon problem much later. So do a lot of repetition, follow a teacher, and then also don't forget your cardio, to have the cardio system, because the oxygen will bring you oxygen to your brain. Then you think better, you sleep better, and you make love better.
May I take a picture of yours?
Yes, yes.
To send to the people that are asking for, and to put in my site,
yes,
my website, personal
and
one.
And can we also take a picture together for the people on their site?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, look, but first I will take one of yours. And...
Hold on. Yeah.
How do you like to... Okay.
No.
Keep it. Keep it. Let's see.
You tell me.
Yeah,
you can. You know how to shoot, huh?
I don't know. You're going to see later. I'm going to put it there.
Hey, you'll see the way she shot. Was that the best? Just that the, you know, when the line go.
Now, may I put you?
Let's do a picture together for the
okay,
side too.
Later.
You shoot, sir. Come. Come
vem aqui, bate uma aqui, bate uma da gente aqui, então. But I still have a ping pong
can
with you.
You see, can you see I'm from the far west?
Whoa! I want to have a ping pong with you, huh?
Come closer, face shot for the web,
for the light.
I see already. I talk web.
Okay, now to finish
Yes.
With the interview, I'm going to put you a ping pong. May I?
Yes. What's a ping pong?
Ping pong, like this. I put ping, you answer pong very quickly.
Oh, then let me drink some water.
Okay.
Ping pong.
Let's go. No próximo bloco, a gente volta com bate-bola e a fantástica foto do Lambi Lambi. Até já. De volta de frente, cara a cara com Jean Claude Van Damme, que tá sempre pronto para qualquer coisa e tá pronto pro bate-bola. Bate-bola. Bate-bola, jogo rápido. The best and the worst movie. Not yours. Whatever comes to your head, you know, to your mind. The best and the worst movie.
Ben-Hur, best movie.
That you ever saw, that you remember?
The best movie, yeah, because I was with my father also, yeah, and it was spectacular, it was with love, everything was there. Worse, I would choose one of mine, because it will be unfair to, yeah, Inferno.
A hero and a villain.
No, not Inferno. Universal Soldier 2.
Okay.
The Wars.
And a hero and a villain.
A hero, a child.
And a villain,
an adult.
An obsession and a wish.
An obsession, it's I want to be, and a wish is be want to, which means think about the gold, you'll be there, and you're starting already. Because if you think about the gold before the steps, understand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
A struggle and a victory.
A victory, it's a miracle, which is a birth. That's the first sign of the power of nature, when 1 + 1 = 1. That's a victory. And a struggle is life, which is beautiful, because you can struggle beautifully with passion. So when people say we have to struggle, they can struggle for passion, like a painter, like the best valet taxi in the world. He likes his taxi, he likes his little music. So what? That's his life, he likes it. Leave him alone, he's the best.
Jean-Claude Van Damme on Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Oh, la la.
Oh, come on.
Me on me?
Yeah, try it.
For what, mentally?
A definition about yourself.
Oh, about myself?
The qualities and the unqualities.
Oh, I can do that in a word. a good teacher. Take it seriously. Because sometimes people, they try to help their son, daughter, friends, with real feeling. It's not me all the time, because sometimes I say stuff and I mean it. Sometimes I say stuff, I always mean it, but I do them. But a good teacher sometimes supposed to learn what he's supposed to teach, you know? If I have a son, and I say to him years ago, don't smoke, he said to me, Dad, why are you smoking? You should say, thank you. So when somebody tells you something for your benefit, accept it, even if he doesn't, you know?
Yeah.
So you have the two Van Damme here. You've got the guy who doesn't do nothing, and you have the teacher who maybe do something.
So that's Jean-Claude Van Damme on Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Yeah, I talk to myself to remind me what's good and bad. I've got to, because my next movie will be The Monk.
Will it be?
Yeah, well, I'll have to shave my head. That's why I'm losing so much weight.
Are you kidding, or is it true?
No, I've got to go to training. I'm going to go with a bowl of rice in Malaysia.
Who's going to direct?
Ringo Lam.
Again? The third one?
The Dictator.
Yeah? Are you going to shoot like in Malaysia? It's an
award, huh? It's got 5 awards last year.
Are you going to shoot in Malaysia?
In China, in a tundra, with a real Shaolin temple.
You lived once in Hong Kong, didn't you?
Yeah, but we're going to leave now in 10. It's going to be cold. Are we finished the interview?
Yes.
You want to leave me right away?
No, you want your agents. They are calling us and saying, stop the interview. It's finished. It's finished, okay. So I'm finishing. Let's see the picture.
But hold on. Where's the people? They can still see us? Let's say bye-bye to the people.
Wait a minute. Let me show you. Oh, my God. With no focus at all.
What?
Let's see them there.
It's a great
better
picture.
There. Do you like it?
I'm happy.
Do you like it? Are you?
Yeah, I'm happy.
Oh,
look.
Thank you. My God, Jean Claude Van Damme gosta da foto que eu fiz. He likes it. Thank you, darling.
You're so nice.
You too.
You're so nice, really.
Thank you very much. And here for my people, if you want.
Okay. Put the light on. Thank you. No camera. Anyway, what should I say?
Well, I don't know.
Tell me.
Well,
what should I say?
Say, eu gostei de conversar
I'm
com vocês.
Say, I'm going to say you helped me. I feel good here.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I feel good here. I feel just good in Brazil. And that's the most important. You know?
Great.
And I'm a complicated man. And me, I feel good. It's difficult.
Well, you did it.
Convide Dios.
Okay. Fiquem com Deus.
Fique com Deus, ok? Fique com Deus. No religion, fique com Deus.
Adeus. Fica aqui ainda. Stay here. Oh. We are finishing.
Fique com
Tchau.
We're going to start a war.